Hey everybody, I'm Wesley Willis here at the Rio Costero Ranch in Bayview, Texas for the Young Life Invitational Clay Shoot. Everyone is gathered here at this event to support Young Life, an organization dedicated to improving kids' lives and helping them start their journeys into faith. Its positive values and life-changing mentors have helped millions worldwide, and it all started right here in Texas. Today we're going to get to know this organization a little better and have some fun along the way. Let's get started.
It's time to hit the road and discover Texas with Wesley Willis. Get ready to travel deep into the heart of the Lone Star State, meeting friendly folks and exploring fascinating places. Experience a way of life like nowhere else in the world as we uncover the rich history and culture of Texas. Discover adventure. Discover excitement. Discover Texas with Wesley Willis.
It's early in the morning at Rio Costero Ranch in Bayview, Texas, and the crowd has already lined up for the Young Life Invitational Clay Shoot. Once everyone registers and grabs their complimentary gift bags, they gather around for a meeting with the event organizers, where the event rules are explained in detail and they're given a map of the ranch and shooting stations. After an important safety lesson and a brief prayer, the teams are ready to go. The ranch spans 1,000 acres. Luckily, the generous people at LF Motors were kind enough to donate some Polaris Rangers for the event. The teams load up and are sent on their way. Rio Costero is the ideal place to hold an event like this. Every shooting station has something different to offer. 1 minute you're shooting from high above the water, and the next you're at ground level with some very exotic wildlife. Just looking around, it's easy to forget why you're here. They've got a lot of territory to cover, so let's take a moment for a word from Dave Osborne, who will tell us more about this great cause we're supporting.
Hello from the Rio Costero Ranch in Los Fresnos, Texas. I'm Dave Osborne, CEO of the VTX1 Companies, and we're here today along with Texas Regional Bank as primary co-sponsors of the annual Young Life, Young Lives Invitational Outdoor Event. Our goal is to raise money to send young people from the Rio Grande Valley to Young Life Camp to show them a better way of life by deepening their Christian faith. Young Life is a family of faith-based programs that bring young people, many for the first time, into a Christian spiritual experience. Young Lives is for teen moms and dads and provides additional training and education on caring for a child and running a household budget. Young Lives also stresses high school completion and acquiring a post-secondary education. Young Lives leaders are always present to provide support for teen parents who need marketable workplace skills. We view these as worthy and necessary goals to assist South Texas young people in achieving a better, more fulfilling life. Our company believes that all community service is important. We assisted Loaves and Fishes in 2017 and are working with Habitat for Humanity for our 2018 program. Our primary focus, though, will always be about young people and preparing them to become responsible, contributing members of their communities. In addition to Young Life and Young Lives, VTX1 supports the Teach for America program and the local Boy Scout Council.
The tournament was well underway. Temperatures were quickly approaching the 100 degree mark, but that wasn't slowing anybody down. Everyone was having fun showing off their shooting skills, though some shots were a little trickier than others. When we got to Station 9, the guys there were having a great time. That's where I caught up with Young Life's Joe Wilson. Today we're here with the Young Life Area Director, Joe Wilson. Joe, can you go ahead and tell us a little bit about the organization Young Life?
Yeah, absolutely. Young Life was founded in 1941. It started out in Gainesville, Texas, by a guy named Jim Rayburn. He was a Presbyterian youth minister, and his senior pastor essentially told him, hey, look, I've got the kids coming to church. I need you to go find the kids that aren't at church. The way that Young Life takes place is that it's not just an event. It's not a once-a-week club. There's so much more that's going on behind the scenes. We would start with our early ministries being one we call wildlife with middle school students. And then as they graduate kind of middle school and head into their freshman year, they can enter into Young Life, which is our high school ministry. And as they move on and graduate Young Life their senior year, we have Young Life College. With our teen mom program, what's really been really awesome is we've watched a lot of those teen moms begin a relationship with Christ, start partnering with these mentor moms and actually find value in their relationship with their baby's daddy. We provided marriage counseling for that, and we've seen teen moms and baby's daddies get married together, go through premarital counseling, and now, in fact, we have some of them that are coming back and helping leading other teen moms to a relationship with Christ and healthy relationships that make a much more supportive foundation for their children going forward.
Mm-hmm. Wow. So, I mean, it must work if they're coming back and wanting to volunteer and stay involved in the program.
That's right. We also have our special needs program, and so that one is very unique. You have kids that are all over the spectrum with autism and Down syndrome, and so you'll have kids as young as 13, 14 years old that will go to camp with us and will be a part of our weekly ministries and that leaders will have relationships with. And sometimes they're 21, 22, 23 years old, and there's just not a great place to, like, you know, say, hey, we're going to send you on to this next transition, because they obviously have their challenges. But it's also one of the most fascinating and sweetest ministries we have, because until you step foot into the lives of families with kids with special needs, you'll never understand what they go through. But you also never understand the huge blessing these kids are, because they take our volunteers at their core, at who they are. There's nothing we're going to give them. They don't care how cool we are or how much money we have or any of that. They just love that we're there and we're in their life. And it's such a life-giving ministry to be a part of that one.
Well, the relationships that these kids are having, you know, it continues on into their adulthood. Is it just the kids with special needs, or is that, you know, the middle school kids and high school kids? Is that relationship continuing?
Yeah. I would often tell folks that Young Life is not a flash in the pan. It's really about the long game. There are tons of kids that they have a relationship with their Young Life leader from the time they're in middle school. And you'll see that same Young Life leader be a best man at their wedding, or even maybe officiate their wedding. And so it's really a neat experience to watch somebody who says, you know what, I'm going to make sure this kid understands that they're worth it, and I'm going to be in their life as a friend, as a spiritual mentor, for the rest of their life.
Well, what are we going to be expecting here today on the grounds?
Today at the Rio Costero Ranch, VTX1 and Texas Regional Bank have come together to support Young Life Ministry and to help us get kids to camp. And so a lot of the shooters from around here are friends and family of VTX1 employees and Texas Regional Bank employees as well. And so they kind of pulled together their friends and said, hey, let's go have some fun, experience the outdoors, shoot some clay targets, and raise money for kids to go to camp. And so we'll have 10 stations, and at each station there is essentially you'll get a chance to shoot 10 targets. And so those will usually be thrown as a true pair. And then after that, they'll score themselves. And then at the end of the event, we'll tally their scores. They will put those in, and we'll rank those and divide those up into categories and award top shooter in four different categories.
Fun. I like that. Yeah, I was going to say, what made you decide to choose the shooting, the skeet shooting, rather than a golf tournament?
Yeah, that's a great question. When we got together with some of our friends, they said, you know, how can we help Young Life? And so a couple of the owners from the Rio Costero Ranch, they came to us and said, look, we've got this great resource, and we want to see it used to give back to the community. We had thought about golf tournaments and fishing tournaments, and really there's a lot of those in the valley, and they all go to support great causes. But we wanted to do something different, and we felt like there was a niche of outdoorsmen who really wanted to give back to the community, but maybe they weren't fishermen or maybe they weren't golf players. And so this gave them an opportunity to do something different. We set up a 100% unique and custom course. And so this course spans pretty much the entire 1,000 acres. It's a 7.5 mile long drive to complete the course. It'll actually take a couple of hours, but that gives a great opportunity for conversation, camaraderie, and a chance for folks to really take in what Texas has to offer, which is beautiful country.
Wow. Yeah, that's true. With all its scenic views and fascinating animals, Rio Costero was a great location for this type of event. I wanted to find out more about the ranch, and who better to ask than one of the guys in charge. Hey everybody, I'm here with Michael Skief, one of the partners of the Rio Costero Ranch and chairman of Texas Regional Bank. Michael, go ahead and tell us about where we are today and what's going to be happening.
Okay, so Rio Costero Ranch was purchased about 6 or 7 years ago by myself and a couple partners, Bobby Ferris and Bill Eliff. The ranch consists of about 1,000 acres, and since we've owned it, we've done a number of things to really reestablish wildlife out here. As you can see, this lake here is something we added, and another lake to the north, and done a lot of improvements that help out the wildlife habitat. We've got whitetail deer, nilgai, javelina, pigs, turkey, and we've got alligators. So if you better watch close at these lakes, you might see an alligator around here.
Oh gosh. Other than, you know, the wildlife, you mentioned earlier this is your second year. So what makes you keep coming back to this event specifically?
So Joe brought this to our attention a couple of years ago, and we took it to the board of directors of Texas Regional Bank and decided that this was an event we wanted to sponsor for the youth of the Valley. We participate financially and through hours worked and come out here and help the shooters. You have a lot of really good shooters out here. In fact, there's a lot of competition shooters that come out. Because of the way we set up the range, we set up 10 stations all through the ranch, and we use Polaris Rangers from LF Motors to run through the ranch, and they get to see a big part of the ranch and get to see a lot of wildlife.
Were the locations of the stations, you know, specific, or were they just kind of spread out, or did you choose each location for a purpose?
You know, I don't know a lot about the sporting clays, but what I understand is you choose locations to create illusion. Mm-hmm. So, you know, for example, we're standing over water. Well, my understanding is they want to throw sporting clay targets over the water because that gives you a different view than if you throw it over a tree or out in the field or going away or on a side. And that's kind of what got explained to me. So we use all the different elements of the ranch to create a different environment for each shot. And I think, again, I think the sporting clays gentlemen did a great job of doing that.
Mm-hmm. And with this year being such a good turnout, will we expect to see you again next year?
I guess that's a plug question to get us to commit again. No, I think so. The bank's enjoyed seeing this. We hope that this continues year after year, and it seems to be gaining a lot of momentum.
Now that we've heard from Michael, let's go hear what the other partners of the ranch have to say.
I'm Bobby Ferris. I'm vice chairman of Texas Regional Bank and one of the owners of the ranch here.
Awesome.
And I'm Bill Ellif, and I'm an owner of the ranch here.
They're having a great time. The weather's cooperating. Everything is working really well.
How did Young Life choose this location? How did you get involved with Young Life?
We both started getting involved in Young Life several years ago because of the great ministry that they do. And from that, it's just evolved that we had this ranch and we wanted to share that with Young Life.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. And we've obviously both been involved in it for a long time. My kids grew up through Young Life when they were younger, and you know, Young Life's got just a great ministry, and it's neat to be able to take something like this shooting event that nobody's really done down here and support it like that. And I think Young Life's going to try to spread that throughout the state. Well, you know, it's a little bit of a competition, and there's some ringers out here, the guys that are really, really good and would like to take home all the prizes, you know. And, but it's just a fun event, and I don't think it's I don't think there's a winner or a loser in it. It's just the only winner, I guess, is Young Life. You know,
so. Friendly competition.
Oh, that's right.
Right.
Exactly.
Now we're going to meet someone that Young Life has had a personal effect on, Eli Coronado, who has been involved in Young Life for many years.
I came into Young Life probably with my wife. She brought me in. She was through Young Lives, the teen parenting. She brought me in, and it's just changed me. I learned about accepting Jesus in there, you know, and just everybody there is real helpful. They're there to support you.
Mm-hmm. How long have you been involved in Young Life?
In Young Life, I say I've been involved maybe three years. And like I said, it's mainly been through Young Lives. Mm-hmm. Just recently, I started volunteering, helping with Young Life, but it's been Young Lives mainly.
Awesome. And so are you excited to be at this event and having fun?
Yes, I looked forward to this morning. I couldn't sleep. Well, last night I couldn't sleep.
Oh.
I've been up since about 5:30. My wife's been bugging me. Hey, what are you doing? It's like, well, I got to be there an hour early. I can't miss this. So it's
exciting. And since you've been involved and you really enjoy it, you know, what do you say to other people that are looking to get involved?
As far as for people to get involved, don't be scared. I mean, would be the thing. You know, you have to just explore. The people here, they're not going to judge you. They're not going to make fun of you. But regardless of what your story is, they're here to help. They're here to support you and love you.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. And so are you going to be able to come back next year to the event?
I'm hoping that next year, yes, I can come again.
Through time, effort, and patience, the men and women of Young Life are building real relationships with these kids and helping them find their place in the world. When we return, we'll take a firsthand look at the wonderful work being done by the women of Young Lives.
Hold on to your hat. We'll be right back.
Being a teenager can be hard, but being a teen mom is unbelievably difficult. Many times, grades are the first thing to suffer. The people at Young Lives, like Marilyn Osborne, have made it their mission to make sure that these girls complete their education and don't fall through the cracks.
The Young Lives program is an extension of the Young Life program, providing support and mentoring to pregnant and parenting teens. Young Lives leaders develop relationships of trust with these teen parents who often face overwhelming obstacles. They struggle to provide for their baby's needs while trying to complete their high school education. Harlingen CISD offers teen parenting classes on three campuses, and Young Lives leaders visit these classes twice each month during the school year. We connect girls to the Rio Grande Valley's basic health programs and schedule representatives to educate our girls regarding a wide array of topics crucial to the health and the development of their babies. Some of these topics include parent and child nutrition and obesity prevention, child abuse prevention, legal rights and parental responsibilities, positive parenting and toddler discipline, connection to healthcare providers, identifying and confronting dating and domestic abuse, job interview preparation, applying for college and financial aid. The Young Lives program strives to provide loving support to these most vulnerable young women and to instill in them a strong sense of identity, purpose, and self-worth. We encourage them to set goals, achieve their potential, and nurture their children in healthy, loving environments. We believe that being the hands and feet of Christ is the best way to help these young parents become productive citizens and break the cycles of generational poverty.
Helping these girls with their education is extremely important, but it's only the beginning of what Young Lives is all about. The emotional support and spiritual guidance offered by the Women of Young Lives helps to empower teen moms to make the choices and achieve the goals that will lead to a better future for them and for their children. I was able to stop in and visit with the girls. Once a month, Young Lives invites teen moms and dads and their children to a night of dinner, fun, and prayer. These kids have built friendships out of trust and understanding for one another. I had a blast meeting the girls and learning more about their experiences over conversation and games. It's during these once-a-month meetups that these new parents get to feel like teenagers again, with the help of the group leaders and volunteers. These ladies are happy to help out however they can, whether it's driving babies to the doctor, finding money for diapers, writing resumes, or getting the girls to job interviews. The heart of Young Lives is the relationship between teen moms and their mentors. Deanna Murphy, the volunteer coordinator, told us more about the program.
One-on-one mentoring is where we can make the most difference. And that is when a woman just says, yes, I'll mentor one girl. And she does that on their best schedule. It will look different for every woman and every girl, but the main thing what she's doing is she's getting to know that girl. She's walking with her in her life wherever she is, whatever point she is in her life, and she's figuring out a way that she can help make a difference. Not to help financially necessarily, not to rescue her in any way, but to help her learn to be strong on her own and independent on her own, because that's really what we want for all of our girls, to be learn to be successful and financially independent so that they can learn to take care of themselves and their babies.
Mm-hmm. And I can imagine those relationships start off kind of awkward at first. How does it build?
Well, it's just naturally, slowly. It's not like you can't start off running. You just have to start off on a crawl. And it is awkward at first. And a lot of times they don't take your texts right at first or your phone calls right at first. But if you just are consistently mm-hmm. checking in with them, then eventually at some point they're going to break down and respond back, Mm-hmm. And all you have to say is, hey, want to go get a coffee? And most of them, they're like, go get a coffee. But they're like, sure. And so you go, and if it's time for them to open up and spill their guts, It's amazing what you can hear over a cup of coffee.
Okay, go ahead and tell us about this camp that these girls get to go on. We want to know about their experience and all the fun they get to have. We want to know about the atmosphere.
Okay, well, for the last 8 years, we have taken a group of girls from Harlingen and the surrounding areas up to Camp Buckner in Marble Falls. They rent it out, and it's just Young Lives Week when we get there. And there are about 200 other teen moms there from around Texas and surrounding areas. And there are all kinds of fun activities there, like a fabulous huge ropes course and zip line and a huge big slide that goes down into the lake and canoes and paddle boards. And it's just all kinds of fun for these girls. Plus, we all get to have our own cabins. This last year, we took 11 girls and 10 babies, and we had 3 leaders, and we all stayed in the same cabin for the whole time together.
What was that like?
Well, it can be really loud at night, especially the first night or two while everybody's trying to get adjusted. Mm-hmm. But it's like a huge slumber party. Mm-hmm. And so we all settle in, and, you know, it's so fun. The girls end up being, you know, having so much fun and getting so close together. And they're really sweet the way they help each other with their babies. There's also fabulous programs that are prepared for them. There's professional speakers that give a program every single night that they get to hear. And it, you know, they get to hear about, you know, Jesus, and they get to hear about a God that loves them and that they are His daughter, and they are not an accident. Their babies are not accidents, and He has a plan for their lives. Every single girl that we've ever taken to camp, you can see a difference in them when we leave and when we get back on the bus and when we come home. And they're just happier. And, you know, they're somebody's daughter, and they just maybe haven't had the same maybe support at home, or they haven't had the same opportunities that, say, you know, my kids have had and other people's kids have had. But, you know, they have every, you know, they need every chance and opportunity to do anything that they want to do with their lives. And we believe in them, and we think that they can.
Spending the evening with these girls was very moving. They shared their personal stories, giving me a better understanding of what Young Lives is all about, which led me to one last question for Joe. So how can someone get involved in Young Life?
That's a great question. Getting involved in Young Life is pretty easy. They can really just reach out to us. They can visit our website. It's at younglife.org, and in there they can enter in their area code and find the nearest Young Life office to them. Mm-hmm. And then they'll contact the area director or the staff responsible for that area, and they will have a conversation with them and kind of show them what they have available in the area, and then they can go and be trained and background checked, and then they'll be put on a ministry team and start being deployed to the local school.
And how can, what can someone who is volunteering, what can they get out of being a part of an organization like Young Life?
Yeah, I think any organization where you get to give back, you usually receive more than you give. Mm-hmm. In the way that it makes you feel and just being a part of your community. But giving to Young Life and volunteering with Young Life or becoming a donor with Young Life, it's an investment in your community. It's an investment in kids' lives. And so I think the feeling you get at the end of the day when you know that you've had an opportunity to make a difference and you see a kid change and their life impacted as the gospel comes into their world, there's not a better use of your time and energy than that.
We are so lucky that our community supports us so much. People have a real, they have a heart for these girls. The fact that we're reaching 2 generations at once is, I think, something that everyone feels good about being a part of. And so people like to get behind that and support it, and they are. Their people are so generous with us.
And that generosity and support really shine at an event like this one. VTX1 and Texas Regional Bank contributed greatly as the name sponsors, but so many other sponsors from a wide variety of businesses and industries helped so very much. It's amazing how the community really comes together when there are people in need. Everyone who participated had a lot of fun, and they made some memories that'll last a lifetime.
Today's skeet shooting event has been great fun, and we're all ready to enjoy a great lunch and cool down in the shade with a cold beverage. So please consider joining us in support of the Young Life and Young Lives. Thanks.
You've now seen what Young Life is all about, and you met a few people who are making a difference. To keep doing their good work, organizations like this need people like you. Whether it's your time, money, or just spreading the word, you could have a huge impact on these kids' lives. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.